Hi everybody, welcome to the very first lecture of Fluids class. I can tell you are all very excited. I know that I am. No matter what you have heard about this class, I promise you it will be a good experience. So we're going to start by answering what I think is a very important question for this first lecture, which I think many of you are probably wondering, which is, why is fluids so important? I think that's probably a nicer way of saying what you are all actually really wondering, which is, why is fluids so required, right? This is a required class and is, no matter where you go to school. But why? Why do we even care that much about how fluids move and behave? We are mechanical engineers. We like gears and stuff. Well, let me show you. We're going to answer this question by looking at a car. So here is our car. You'll quickly find I'm not the best drawer in the world, but I draw a lot, so you'll just have to get used to it. So here is our car. I'm going to show you all the ways that a fluid is important to the operation of a car. So number one, in the back, we've got a gas tank, right? And that gas tank is full of fuel. And we need to get that gas up to this square, which is obviously our engine. Well, luckily, our fuel is a liquid, gasoline. And liquid fuel is easily transported. Imagine if instead of a car fueled by gasoline, we had coal-powered cars. That would be a lot harder to make nearly as convenient and efficient as they are now. All we have to do is put this little tiny pump inside the gas tank, and you can pump the fuel very easily and efficiently right into the engine. Okay, now inside the engine itself, we've got this cylinder and a piston inside of it. And then we're inserting air. And inside the air, we've also dispersed some fuel. So there's another kind of really cool thing, which is because we're working with a liquid, the air and the fuel can mix very easily. Sorry, not a liquid, a fluid. But because we have two fluids, the fuel and the air, they can mix really easy. Again, if we had a solid fuel or a solid oxidizer, that would be really hard to mix them so well, so quickly. If we want our engine to work fast, we need to mix these things quickly. Okay, another thing is that our fuel, which is a fluid, is oxidized in another fluid, air. Okay, so we're oxidizing our fuel, which is a fluid, with air, which is another fluid, and this kind of relates back, right? It's easily mixed with that, and so we can get very efficient, quick combustion, which is essential if this thing is going to go up and down like 3,000 times a minute. Okay. That's not all. I mean, so far we've just talked about the fuel, but there's so many other places we're using fluids inside of a car, right? This car is going to get really, really hot because it's just, you know, a continuous explosion inside of there. So we need something to cool it off. Well, that's where the radiator comes in, right? We're going to have air flowing through this radiator, taking the heat away. But we even need to get the heat to the radiator. Well, that's where we've got coolant. A fluid that actually flows through our engine, gathers the heat, brings it to the radiator, where the air then takes that heat away. So we're using fluids in two different ways there. So we'll just write this as our coolant is going to maintain our engine temperature. And it does that using fluids in multiple ways, both to gather the heat and then to remove that heat. All right. Likewise, inside of our engine, right? We've got all of these pieces which are all turning and moving relative to each other. And there's a lot of pieces that rub together. If we want efficient operation, we need them to rub as smoothly as possible. So we reduce friction in our vehicle using something. We need something that fits very conveniently into very small spaces, right? Well, a fluid can do that for you. So we're going to reduce friction, in this case, using some motor oil. Okay, there's even more ways that fluids interact with a vehicle, though. As we drive this direction, then turns out there's something in the way, air. And so as we drive, that air is going to move around our vehicle and is going to induce drag and affect how much work the car has to do. And so here, a fluid isn't helping us, it's hurting us, but it's nonetheless a fluid. And so we've got to think about air resistance in our car design. And so you see, I mean, just from delivering the fuel to turning that fuel into kinetic energy, to cooling the engine, and even to what's getting in the way, fluids is a huge part of a car design. Also, going over this helps us to see a few of the advantages are cool things about fluids. Okay, so I think the first and most important cool thing is what actually makes a fluid. And we're going to define this more exactly in the next lecture. What I'm writing now is a very poor description of what makes a fluid, but we'll say that a fluid adopts new shapes very easily. You know, if I have a chunk of metal and I want to turn it into a cylinder, then I have to like get a hammer and smash it into that, or get a really sharp thing and shave it down into a cylinder. If I want a fluid to look like a cylinder, I just pour it into a pipe and it's a cylinder. If I want it to look like an ice cube, I pour it in an ice cube tray. You know, it can be any shape you want. And I guess my point here was that it's easily formed into a new shape, much easier than a solid, and that it can be any shape you want. Okay, probably the most subtle thing about a fluid, but I think really cool, is that when you have a fluid moving, we kind of just think of it as fluid, but really what you're doing is you are transporting energy and mass. Energy and mass are transported by a fluid. Let's go back to our car example. Most of these things had something to do with energy, right? Here, the fuel, we are just transporting chemical energy as a fluid from the back of the car to the front. Likewise, here our coolant circulating, that was transporting energy, thermal energy, away from the engine into the outside. And so a fluid in those cases was acting, I mean, we didn't really care about the fact it changed shape easily. We did because that means it's easy to move around. But really what we wanted was a very, very convenient way of transporting energy and or mass. And a fluid is the most efficient way to do either of those things. Like we saw with the fuel and the oxidizer as well, because fluids adopt any shape and adopt that shape easily, they are easily mixed with each other. This is just a few things that I could think of in a minute. Really, because fluids are so different than a solid, they make many things possible. I think that's just a good thing to underline. All right, so the point of this lecture is really just to get you excited, help you see that fluids is important. Remember, we're answering the question, why is this class required? Why do you have to be here? And so I thought it'd be fun to point out just a few, actually a lot of applications where you see fluids being used or is important or fundamental to the physics of how that thing's working. I thought we'd start with life itself. So blood flow, breathing, those are important. Life. And those are both fluids. Think about it, blood and air. Those are two of the most important things that you need to survive, and they're both a fluid. Okay. Other things that involve fluids. We got swimming, pumps, fans, jets, all kinds of jets, fighter jets, fluid jets. What about a turbine? Or an airplane? How about a boat? A ship? A river? Again, I'm just listing things that involve fluids. Wind turbines, what about a pipe, of course? Missiles, those use fluids. An iceberg, I thought that was an interesting one. I got some of these out of our book, to be honest. We already talked about engines. Filters are inherently usually using fluids. Ooh, sprinklers. And then my personal favorite, rockets. So, to get us excited about fluids, I thought we would watch a video of a rocket.
Announce pressure water system armed. T minus 10.
Try and look for fluids here. I thought the people cheering was an appropriate place to end. So that was pretty cool, right? Let's see, get our marker back here. So we've got a rocket, which is using all kinds of fluids. First of all, you're pushing really hot gases outside of your nozzles in the back, and that is exactly what allows you to escape the atmosphere. Without this fluid, you could not do this, and we would be stuck on Earth. Again, fuel and oxidizer both stored as fluids so that they can easily be transported to the nozzles. Also, this rocket is passing very quickly through the atmosphere. We didn't see it, but you can even see shock waves coming off of this rocket. So, fluids, is really cool. And just think about, people always talk about rocket scientists. They're like, oh man, it's not rocket science. Well, guess what rocket science is? Fluids. So get excited.